What's up, guys? I'm gonna show you how to light up your scene quickly with Twinmotion. Let's get right into the video. All right, so we have our conference room scene here. And as you can see, you know, we don't have any lighting at the moment. So I'm gonna show you how to light up your scene. So we're gonna go to materials. We're gonna go down to neons, and you have different options here: neon 1, 0, 2, sharp blink, and police beacon. So they got a lot of different options here that you can use. I think this is pretty cool. We'll just kind of play around just for a second. So if you just kind of hover over your lights, that feature would show the neon sharp blink, but we're not gonna use that. I just kind of want to show you kind of what that looks like for an example. For this one, we're gonna use neon 2, and we go over here to our options here and kind of change the glow. You can kind of change the glow as bright as you want. I'm gonna keep it at 100. And then you can click on details, you can kind of change the texture, you can change the temperature and saturation. I'm gonna leave those alone for now. And so we got our pendant light going. Let's see about these strip lights above. So I'm just gonna drag over between my strip lights. And as you can see, that lights up our strip lights. And then as we move over, you can see that we have recessed cans, and they don't have any lighting set up for them just yet. The recessed lights, I kind of play around with them a little differently. Normally I would go to the library and we will add the light directional. And you would just hover over, and you want this to kind of line up with your lights. So once you got that omnidirectional light centered, I want that to go here. So the intensity is at 300. We want to bring that down to 100. And attenuation is at 5. I think that's fine. We have our color here. We can change the temperature of the color temperature to more of a warm light. Right now we're working with warm lighting. You can also change it to more of a blue tint kind of lighting, to kind of a cooler lighting, if you will. We're gonna stick to 45. And another thing is you got shadows here, so I always enable my shadows because that's gonna kind of help give you some more realism to your rendering whenever you use Path Tracer or Lumen. So as you can see, I have other recess cans that need to be lit. So what I do is I just copy and paste and just slightly move my lighting here. So I just copied that omnidirectional light. And everything that I, all the features and options that I changed on that one, it will move to this recess can light as well. So copy again, paste, and we'll just move that there too. So now I'm going to select those three. I'm gonna do control copy, control V, and then we're gonna move this over to the other side as well. There you go. All right, so now we're gonna go to our saved image to kind of see what our results are. And look at that, that looks pretty good. So now I'm gonna kind of add a little bit of a bonus. I'm gonna go ahead and see what it looks like in Path Tracer. Guys, if you're liking this video, please do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe. We're gonna do rendering, Path Tracer. Right now it's at set 2830 bounces, max bounces. I'm gonna bring down the samples per pixel just so we can kind of quickly render this. And as you can see, it's looking pretty good. Of course, there's other things you can do to kind of play around with your lighting depending on the outcome you're trying to get.